Good evening. We welcome you live to the Sanctuary of Encounter Church on this Wednesday night.
Wait a second. Now you can see how it feels. You see, lately I've been opening the service, and he comes from behind, and he does all these kind of silly things. He takes my shirt, and he goes up and down like this and like that. Now, you like the way it feels?
That did catch me off guard.
Yeah, catch you off guard. All right, two things. Number one,
yes.
Trim the beard.
Maybe tomorrow.
What do you mean maybe?
We'll see. I got an appointment with my hairdresser.
Your hairdresser, huh? Your hairdresser, huh? Oh, okay. We're not going to go there. Okay. I have an appointment with my hairdresser every day.
Every day, yeah.
In fact, we live together.
Yes, you do.
Don't tell anybody, but I live, don't tell anybody. Welcome. I live with my hairdresser.
That must be a blessing.
We live together.
That's a blessing.
But we're not living together in sin.
Mm.
Because we're married to each other. Pastor Joan, your first lady. Yep. Somebody say first lady.
First lady.
Yeah.
First lady.
You have a P on your hat.
I do.
In baseball, that means Pittsburgh. But I know that you don't represent Pittsburgh because you're a supposed Chicago Cub fan. So what's up with that?
You're right.
So
I'm representing Hispanic Heritage Month.
Well, you know, today is the first day of Hispanic Heritage Month. Today is the first day of his or hers.
His panic because of her.
Say it again.
Hispanic because of her.
Oh, because of Hispanic Heritage Month.
My wife's not watching, is she?
No, she better not. Is that Roberto Clemente?
That is,
Roberto,
yes.
Clemente, one of the greatest baseball players ever. And if you don't like baseball, shame on you. If you don't like baseball, shame on you. Why? Because it's in the Bible.
It is.
It's right there in Genesis chapter 1. In fact, Genesis 1:1 says, in the beginning.
That's it.
You get it?
Woo-hoo!
Woo-hoo!
Hey!
Huh? 10?
10.
I thought we'd get at least 11, but we'll settle for a 10.
12.
Okay, do I hear 13?
Sure.
How about 15?
Yeah.
Genesis 1:1, in the beginning. You know, in baseball, they play innings,
which
right?
Which inning was it?
What team was it?
Which inning? First, second?
Which third? Inning?
How about 9 innings?
No.
10.
God has no beginning, he has no end. In the beginning. B-E-G-G. In the beginning. All right. So Pittsburgh, right?
Pittsburgh.
Roberto,
yeah.
Clemente. So happy Hispanic Heritage Month to all of you Hispanics. We love you. We love you all. And welcome tonight to Encounter Church.
Amen.
But I'm used to him getting on me in the opening, and I don't want to wear a collared shirt because I don't know what he's going to do to me. Anyway, you're going to open up.
Yes, sir.
And then you're going to tell people. In fact, tell them right now.
Okay.
Tell them right now that you're going to be in Atlanta, Georgia tomorrow. And Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, right?
Correct, yes.
Tell everyone what's going on.
Yeah, so this weekend, God's opened a door for me to be in Atlanta and minister at a men's retreat to men who have dealt with sexual trauma and have overcome homosexuality. So God has opened that door where I'm actually talking about rebuilding the walls of the mind.
Wow.
And the heart out of Nehemiah as well, like Apostle ministered a couple weeks ago. And God is getting ready to do something big. So keep us in prayer. Keep me in prayer. Keep the team in prayer because we believe that God is going to do something big. And there's breakthrough coming that's going to result in a reconstruction of the mind and of the spirit to take these men to a different level.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yeah, let's pray. Stretch your hands toward us, folks. Let's pray. What Pastor Eddie is going to be doing, he's an ambassador of Christ, and he represents the kingdom. He represents you. He represents me, this church. Father, we pray your hand of protection over Pastor Eddie. We pray, Lord, as he ministers, however he ministers, Lord, that he would be used,
yes,
for your honor and glory.
Thank you, Father. Yes,
that the
Lord.
Anointing will be fresh,
yes,
upon him.
Father. Thank you.
And that these dear men, many who are still struggling, will be completely free.
Yes.
And whom the Son sets, yes, free is free indeed.
Yes, yes,
those,
yes,
men that are free will stay free.
Amen.
We pray your hedge of protection over him.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, as he's released with our blessing, as he goes out with our blessing on Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday,
thank you, Lord.
Father, I thank you that I know he'll come back with numerous praise reports.
Yes.
I just know it, Lord.
Yes.
to the glory of God.
Yes.
Lord, it's all because of you.
Yes.
But we thank you for your people that have a part in it as well. Amen. By praying and interceding.
Yes.
So we thank you for this vessel, Father.
Amen.
God.
Yes.
We thank you for this mighty man, Lord God.
Yes.
That he will be an encourager, equipper,
yes,
and a rebuilder, Lord,
yes,
to the glory of God in Jesus' name.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
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 So you're leaving Thursday,
mm-hmm,
through Sunday. So we'll see you tonight, but we won't see you on Sunday.
Correct. Yep.
But you'll be being used for the glory of God. Now,
amen.
Kayleen's going to be here.
She will. Yes, she will.
So the children's ministry, Kayleen will be here. The children will be here. And we'll be praying for you now to the time you get back.
Amen. Amen.
All right?
Amen.
Okay.
Amen.
And you don't have to trim your beard.
A little bit. A little bit. The hair is going to be gone.
All right. Well, whatever.
Bye-bye.
It'll be gone tomorrow.
Can you give me some of that?
I can.
All right.
with a little glue.
Okay. I'll need that too.
Listen, church, together, thank you for praying for me, together as one team, just like our vision, right? To encounter the presence of God and to equip people of all backgrounds to become disciples of Jesus Christ. Labors for his kingdom, one united loving family, having one heart with one purpose, together as one team, touching our community and reaching the world. And that is the God that we serve. He's going to use us all together. Amen. If you have a youth or a young adult, I encourage you to have them join us tonight as we continue our series for such a time as this, with an emphasis on evangelism. Today we discuss about the different aspects of evangelism, from street evangelism, conversational evangelism, to prophetic evangelism, knowing that God is going to use our youth and our young adult to bring in this end time harvest as a result of their obedience, because they were born for such a time as this. So now let's gather together as a family and let's worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We've come for him tonight, for God tonight, for Jesus, for the Holy Spirit, wherever we're at. We've come for him. We've come in our hearts. We've come in our minds, in our focus. So let's just focus our attention on him, focus our eyes on him, and worship him. Oh. about the gifts that he has given us, that he is our portion, he is our healer and our deliverer. So tonight, right now, let's thank him. Let's sing that song to him of thankfulness, of praise, of worship, of adoration. Oh, just sing that new song. Jesus, I thank you. I thank you for your word that heals our diseases. I thank you for the hope of glory. I thank you for the peace that passes all understanding.
Father, we exalt you. You said if you are lifted up, if you're lifted up, you will draw people to you. Folks, we need for the Lord to draw people to him. We want to see your family drawn to him, right? We want to see our co-workers drawn to him, right? We want to see all of our loved ones, all of our loved ones drawn to him, right? We want to see America drawn to him, right? He says if he's lifted up, if he's honored and glorified, he will draw all men unto him. Now we're going to pray. Thank the Lord for the privilege of prayer. Truly, 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 one puts 1,000 to flight, but two, 10,000. We have much more than that tonight, so good things are about to pop. That's right, pop. If any two shall agree about anything, asking anything in faith believing, it will be done. So whatever your prayer request is, as we've been engaging with the Lord in worship, now let's engage in prayer. So I'll give you a moment to comment your prayer request. If it's for a coworker, if it's for an unstuck with God, whatever it is, feel free to comment. If it's something very, very personal, then you can email the church. You can do that. But most of us right now have a prayer request, if not all of us, that we know that we can share publicly. There are some that should be private. Not unspoken, but private. There's a difference. Sometimes people say, I have a special unspoken request. Well, the Bible says we need to speak it out. I mean, I know what they mean. But right now, whatever that request is, even if it means salvation for lost loved ones, rededication for family, whatever it is, healing in body, the Lord sees them all. As we activate our faith in commenting right now, whatever that need is, maybe fear needs to be driven out. Maybe somebody's dealing with discouragement. Maybe a lack in some area, a lack of wisdom maybe, a lack of peace maybe, whatever it is, we're not ashamed. We're family. In fact, the Bible says, confess your faults one to another. Well, I'm not asking you right now to confess your fault. I'm not asking for that. Although the Bible says, confess your faults one with another. See, that's New Testament. That's something that needs to be restored back to the church, where people can honestly tell people how they feel. I mean, what they're going through, so that they can encourage each other. But the Bible says, confess not only your faults, but confess your needs. So this is your opportunity. You can say, I need this, or I'm believing for this. How about that? I'm believing for this. I'm believing for that. Again, if it's very, very personal, you can call the church. If it's very, very personal, you can email the church. But we all have a need right now that we can all engage together with and take them before the Lord in prayer. We can do that. Whatever it is, protection for our children, for our schools, our president, governor, mayor, apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, teacher, Pastor Joni, myself, my children, my family, your family, and the list goes on. Our troops, our kids on the streets, that they would convert their lives to Christ, that God will protect them for racial reconciliation. You know, folks, there's no shortage of prayer requests. There's no shortage of prayer requests. So keep them coming in. Keep them coming in. There's no shortage for prayer requests. But listen to this. There's no shortage or lack in our God and His provision. So we're going to pray. We're going to pray. And God sees them all. God sees them all. We're going to pray. And all these prayer requests that came in from Sunday, from our drive-in service, we're going to pray. And for the roster, we're going to pray. So let's pray. We set our faith in agreement now. We set our faith in unity. We unify our faith right now. We unify our faith right now. Let's start with these prayer requests. Yeah. Some have even written down that most are on the tithing and offering envelopes, but some are even written on paper. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, let's set our faith in agreement right now. Are you ready? Are you ready? Let's set our faith in agreement right now, where mountains are going to move. Mountains are going to move. This anointing is getting stronger. In the name of Jesus, Satan, the Lord rebuke you. You foul spirit of fear, you foul spirit of doubt and unbelief, we come against you, not God's people. We come against every tormenting devil, every seducing spirit, every confused spirit, every lie, every vain imagination. We bind you by the blood of Jesus. This anointing is strong. We bind you in Jesus' name. Keep writing in those comments of prayer requests, because the fire of God is here. The fire of God is here. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We declare healing, deliverance, peace, strength, direction, healing, wisdom, perseverance, restoration of all things, my children, for your perfect will to be done in our lives, for my eyes to be healed, for my stomach to be made well, in the name of Jesus. God sees them all. Spirit of death, you must go in Jesus' name. For peace and the recovery of all things in Jesus' name. For my children, my grandchildren, protection over their lives in Jesus' name. For every single woman, every woman who is single, who's believing God for a mate, we stand with you. Every man believing for a mate, we stand with you. For my kids, my family, my children, in Jesus' name, we believe. This roster called in Calendar Church. When you pray in the Spirit, it's the perfect prayer. When you pray in the Spirit, you're praying for things that you didn't even realize you were praying for. Let's pray in the Spirit. Come on. Jesus, in your mighty name, for these families, Lord. For your family. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, be made well now. Be made well now. Jesus, this anointing is flowing. This anointing is flowing. Jesus, for you.
Continue to pray in the Spirit. Father, we pray for our nation. Father, we pray for the nation of Israel. Father, we pray for the nations of the world. Have your way, Lord God. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh, Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, we pray, Father God, for the church, Father. Father, we pray for boldness, for courage, Lord God. We pray, Father God, for encounters with you, for greater hunger, Lord God, for a desire for more and more of you. Lord God, send revival. Bring unity, Father God, in your church today, in Jesus' mighty name. We pray for covenant keeping, for honor, Lord God, for unity, Lord God, for loyalty and passion, Father God, for your will to be done in our lives and in your church today, Father God. We pray, Lord God, for forgiveness, Lord God. We pray for laborers in the field, Lord God, in Jesus' name. We pray for those that are sick in body, those that are looking and longing to be healed. Thank you, Father God, for your healing touch in Jesus' mighty name. Father God, we thank you for all those in authority, spiritual authority, governmental authority, Father, parents, Lord God, every authority, Father God. We pray your blessing upon them. Encouragement, Father God. Wisdom, Lord God. Father God, continue the discernment for this day and hour. Use them and raise them up, Father God. We pray your blessing and your hedge of protection. The blood of Jesus is upon them in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we pray for repentance to rise up rise up from your church today in Jesus' mighty name. And Father God, we thank you, Father God, that we are the church arising. We are the church arising in Jesus' name. Father, anoint us for this day that we are in. Father, take us, Lord God, and use us, Lord God, as your servants, as your bondservants, as your laborers in the field, in Jesus' mighty name. And right now I want you to pray for every lost person in your family, those in your neighborhood, those on the job, those you come across in the shopping centers. Father, we pray for them. Save them, we pray, for all eternity in Jesus' name. And use us, Lord God. Use these hands as weapons of war. Use our words to speak life, Lord God. Use us, Lord God, to break the yoke of bondage in Jesus' name. And now I want you to give the Lord the greatest shout of praise. Hallelujah!
Woo! Fire of God is here. Over every prayer request that you've commented on, over every prayer request that you commented, that you wrote in, just like the ones you write in with your hand on the offering envelopes, or in some cases on a piece of paper. So right now, every single request that is coming in, that has come in the name of Jesus, we declare it done now. Whoever you are, whatever it is, we declare it. The Father sees it all. The Father sees it all. We declare it done now by the blood of the Lamb of God Almighty. In the name of Jesus, it is done. It is finished. And now we give God the glory and the honor and the praise. He's still doing it. He's still doing it. He's still doing it. He said it's finished on the cross, but he's still working it out right now. Some of you are still being healed, still being delivered, still being set free. Let's rejoice in the God of our salvation. Let's rejoice in the God of our salvation with hands lifted high and voices to the sky.
Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Open. Open the floodgates of heaven. Open. Open the floodgates of heaven. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain.
Folks, wow. Where would we be without this anointing? Where would we be as a church without the anointing? Most churches are known for something. McDonald's is known for hamburgers. Taco Bell is known for tacos. KFC is known for chicken. You get it. Encounter Church is known for something. the anointing of the Holy Spirit. We don't claim to have everything, to know everything, but we know what our lane is. We love all, and we do our best in every ministry. We do our best in every ministry. But this church is known. This church is known as a friend to the Holy Spirit. As a friend to the Holy Spirit. Thank God for the Holy Spirit. Thank God for the Holy Spirit. Some of you are still being healed right now. Some of you are still being delivered right now. It's okay. It's a good process. Some are instantaneous. Some are instantaneous. Some are overnight. Some are within a day. But I know God's doing something now. He's touching you all now. He's healing many now. But I'm just in my spirit hearing the Lord. My spirit is so like, man, you know how it is when you try to tune in your radio? You're getting a little static. Then it's fine-tuned and you say, stop right there, it's perfect. My spirit man right now is just so in tune where the Lord is just telling me to say things. I speak to every broken heart. Be mended now. Be mended now. Somebody spoke words. Lord, heal that broken heart right now. For somebody said something, and perhaps they did not even mean to cause harm, but those words hurt. Lord, heal hearts now. Heal hearts, Lord, that are torn through broken relationships and broken covenants. Heal hearts now, we pray. Lord, we know we're living in perilous days. We know we are. That's why you said, Lord, fight the good fight. Church, be encouraged. Be encouraged. We're in a fight. Yes, we are. America, we're in a fight. Church, we're in a fight, but be encouraged. The Bible calls it a good fight. Good fight. Even when you get hurt and bruised, the Bible still calls it a good fight. We're going to run this race. Mark Lowry. Some of you know who Mark Lowry is, Pastor Derek?
Yeah.
Do you know who Mark Lowry is?
Yes.
Tell the people.
He is just a one-night God. He is used in music, and at times he's been used in comedy as well, but he's really, you know, that southern gospel type music, but he's been used in many ways and through the years.
Yeah.
Through many, many years.
And I don't know if you know this, he used to be part of the Bill Gaither Trio.
Yes.
Yeah. But he's also, like Pastor Derek said, he's a comedian. He's one of the funny, Mark Lowry, he's a comedian as well. In fact, don't tell Janelle I said this. Promise you won't tell Janelle I said this. But Janelle used to have a crush on him when she was just a little girl. She was just, I don't know, 5 years old. She had a crush on him. He's so funny. But he's also serious as well. And he was saying the other day as we were watching one of his podcasts, Pastor Joni and I, he says, church, remember. And what he shared that day, the other day in this podcast, I want to share with you right now. He said, remember this, in this earth right now, this is boot camp. The kingdom is really boot camp. Church, we're in boot camp. And I've got really exciting news for you. The day's going to come that we'll be out of boot camp. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day, glorious day that will be. But may I remind you, we're still at war. We're at war not only against principalities and powers, but there's a war waging within us. Why do people get mad? Why do people break covenants? Because that particular assignment, they failed it. They failed it. because there's a war going on in your mind. 6,200 thoughts a day. There's a war going on in your soul where your spirit is saying one thing, but your mind is saying something totally contrary. And your body wants nothing to do with anything sometimes. So there's a war not only against the devil and against principalities, but there's a war within. There's a war within our members, the Bible says, James says, there's a war within ourselves. But be encouraged, we're in boot camp. Now, boot camp's not a bad place, folks. Because remember this, even in boot camp, the Lord says, I've come to give you life and life more abundantly. Remember that, even in boot camp. Remember this, the joy of the Lord is your strength. Even in boot camp, the joy of the Lord is your strength. And I came across a verse yesterday, September the 14th. Yeah. September the 14th, and it really caught my attention. And I want to read this to you as an appetizer. The other day I gave you Job and Psalms as an appetizer. In Zechariah, who is a prophet, I say that because the Bible says, believe my servants, my prophets, and you will prosper. Calvin Church, I love you. Pastor Joni loves you. Facebook friends, we love you. But be encouraged, folks, by this while we're in boot camp. Because even in boot camp, we not only learn survival. Hear me. I'm prophesying now. Even in boot camp, we not only learn survival, how to survive, but we learn how to revive and thrive. Yeah. Even in boot camp, we learn to thrive, revive, not just survive. But the day is going to come, folks. The day is going to come that we'll graduate in its entirety. And this verse here in Zechariah chapter 14, verse 9. Zechariah chapter 14, verse 9. I know when you look at it, it probably comes in sideways or backwards. I woke up to this yesterday. When I read this, I said, devil, huh. Demons, huh. Zechariah 14:9. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. In that day, there shall be only one Lord and one name. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. And in that day, there'll be one Lord and his name one. Well, yeah, he's my Lord now. Yes. He's your Lord now. Yes. But Satan today is going around like a roaring lion on this earth, seeking whom he may devour. And like I read to you last week, that the earth still belongs to the Lord. But Satan is doing his best to try to possess this land. And Jesus is Lord no matter what. Even now, over your life and my life. But the day's gonna come on this earth, on this planet called earth, he's gonna physically reign. Hallelujah. He's gonna physically reign. There'll be no more racial strife or division or disunity. There'll be no more arguments over masks or no masks, vaccines or no vaccines, indoor service or outdoor service, President Trump or President Biden, it won't matter, because the Lord shall be king over all the earth. In that day, there will be only one Lord. And it won't be me, it won't be you, and it won't be our president or governor or apostles or prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers. It will be the Lord himself. So be encouraged. We're in boot camp. We're here to teach how to survive, but how to revive and thrive for that glorious day. We overcome now, but that day will be. And this is just your appetizer. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. And in that day, there will be only one voice, one Lord, one party, the kingdom and the king, and one name. No other name but the name of Jesus. No other name but the name of the Lord. Sing it, sing it, sing it. No other name but the name of Jesus. Of him.
Name, but the name of Jesus.
Sing it.
Is worthy of glory.
Worthy.
Worthy of honor. And worthy of power and all praise.
Come on, give the Lord a shout of praise. Give the Lord. On three, guys. You ready? Woof! On three. One, two, three. Woof!
Woo!
One, two, three. Woof! One, two, three.
Woof!
You at home together with us. One, two, three. Woof! Wow. That's another word for wow. Woof, call it what you will. It means the power of the Holy Ghost is here and present. Wow. Amen. Pastor Derek, you rock.
You rock.
You rock. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow, church family, do you understand tonight, in the time we've been together, less than 1 hour, God has heard your cry. God has heard your cry. Do you realize God's heard your need? Do you realize God has heard your heart's cry? He's heard your heart's cry, your petition, and he's more than able. He's doing it. What a night of praise. What a night of worship. We love you so, 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 so much. So, 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 so much. Here's my book I wrote. You know how many years ago I wrote this book? This is my 20th anniversary. Covenant keeping. Covenant keeping. Building relationships that last. I wrote this 20 years ago. This is the 20th anniversary. And the back of it says this. Warning. There's a warning. You know, like you see on cigarette boxes, warning. Warning, reading this book may cause you to have yourself committed. You get it? Warning, reading this book may cause you to have yourself committed. I talk about God does nothing apart from covenant. How to build long-lasting relationships. The difference between covenant and control. Get this one. How to handle disagreements while still keeping covenant. How you can have unity through diversity. That's a big one. Because people will be your friends if you're like them. But the minute they find out that maybe you don't think like them all the time. How connection brings protection. How to stay on course to fulfill your destiny. Now look at this picture of me. This is 20 years ago. Look at that face. That a baby face, huh, Pastor Joni? Uh-huh. That's a face only a mother can love. That's a face, well, I guess Pastor Joni fell in love. Anyway, covenant keeping. Now, I'm not trying to endorse it or sell it because I don't have any more to sell. So I'm not trying to merchandise, although I think it's a good book. But it is still available on Amazon. It is. If anybody's interested, it is still available on Amazon. I don't make a penny of it. If you buy it from Amazon, if you do, I guess Amazon makes the money. I sure don't. It's... just one of those deals. You know, I just wrote it to be a blessing. And I mean, at one time we used to sell it and then it would just pay for the cost of the books. We didn't make money on it. But anyway, I just thought I'd bring that up just to remind us all the importance of covenant is really why. And when I looked at it today, I realized, yeah, it was written in 1991. I'm sorry, 2001. Yeah, look at that. 2001. See that? 2001. Oh, I see what you see. You see 1002, right? 1002. Turn that around, would you? Let me see. We do it like that? No. Okay. No, really, I'm sharing this with you because, as Joe prayed earlier, the importance of covenant keeping, folks, like you, that's, I'm proud of you. Who to make covenant with? Here. Who to make covenant with and who to avoid? You know, hurt sheep. Confused sheep. You know, birds of a feather flock together. How to have unity through diversity. And how to handle disagreements and still keep covenant. The devil fears covenant. So I just wanted to share that with you as an encouragement. And also as a reminder that God honors covenant. We're blessed as a church, but I just want to throw that out there. And remind you. All right, now this past Sunday, if you were with us, you know that I ministered on honor, your ticket to God's favor. Honor your ticket to God's favor. And I spoke about the difference between respecting and honoring. And there is a difference, as you learned on Sunday. And if you were not around, I will continue this Sunday, Lord willing, I'll continue this Sunday on honor your ticket to God's favor. We need more of God's favor. And honor is the key. Honor is the ticket. It really is. And honor goes beyond respect. It does. So that's Sunday at 10 a.m. during our drive-in service this Sunday. And we'll have children's ministry as well. Yes, we will. Looking forward to it. And then... it's just a little too soon, but soon I'll be sharing with you about our future plans as a church, and they're all good because for almost 2 years now, believe it or not, almost 2 years, a year and 8 months, however, thereabouts, a year and a half, let's say, you know, God has done a good job leading us, the cloud by day and the fire by night, Numbers chapter 9. He's done a good job, and he'll continue to do a good job leading us. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So, Sunday part two, under the open heaven. It's going to be awesome. Children's ministry as well. Well, Sunday after church, you know, some just stayed around. Well, many stayed around and just fellowshiped because that's what it's all about, fellowship. It really is. I mean, that's one of the major things. It sure is. And it's now, I don't know, 12:30, maybe 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And we're just telling jokes. We're having a good time in the parking lot outside last Sunday telling jokes. And we were all laughing, those that were with us. You know, service was over. Most people went home already. But it was just organic the way it happened. It was David Greer told us a real funny joke. I'll share that another time. It's a real funny one. It's a little longer, so we'll wait off on that one. But it'll be worth it. It'll be worth the wait. It's funny. But then Jeffrey and Patricia Glass had a real good one. Because I never heard of this, you know. We were out there, and I was saying, you know, I wear the pants in my house. My wife tells me which pair to put on. We've all heard of that, right? I wear the pants in my house, but my wife just tells me which pair to put on. We've all heard that. But what Jeffrey and Patricia said, I've never heard before. And then, here it is. You ready? Jeffrey Glass said, in my house, I am the general, and my wife is the major. I'll say that again. This is Jeffrey Glass, and I quote, in my house, I am the general, meaning Jeffrey, and my wife, she is the major, Patricia. She's the major. He says, okay. He said, I make the general decisions, and she makes the major decisions. Oh, that was good. Jeffrey Glass. I never heard that before. Joe, you ever hear that?
Nope.
Pastor Derek, you ever hear that?
Never heard it.
You girls, you ever hear that?
No.
Yeah. I got to repeat it again. In my house, you remember one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready, and four to go? All right. I'm glad we took care of business, right, folks? In the spirit, see, the atmosphere, everything. I love it. Jeffrey Glass said, in my house, I am the general, and Patricia is the major. I make all the general decisions, and she makes all the major decisions. Oh, that is good. Love it, 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 love it. Okay. Well, I've given you that appetizer, haven't I? Yep. Yeah, the Zechariah 14:9, and the Lord shall be king over all the earth in that day. I'm looking forward to that day. There are things that are going to happen first. One is called the rapture. Yes, rapmatismo. Means to be taken up in the Bible. It says rapmatismo, to be taken up. Then there'll be the second coming of Christ. Then there'll be the new Jerusalem and the millennial reign. I'm looking forward to my eternity, and I know you are too. You are too. But until that day, remember, yes, it's true, we're in boot camp, but we're not here just to survive. We're here to thrive and revive. All right? So that was your appetizer. Okay? Tonight we close, although we never close encouraging each other, but we close with 15 reasons to be and stay encouraged. Now, for some of them, I'm going to go faster because it's a review, and I've already shared them with you. But if you're tuning in for the first time, you can go to past broadcasts, and you'll see them there. 15 reasons to be and stay encouraged. Remember, David in 1 Samuel 30 was very, very discouraged. Daniel in 1 Samuel 30 was very discouraged. He was down and out. He was fighting depression. That can happen sometimes to all of us, even in ministry. It can happen. And David was facing depression and discouragement. The enemies were coming against him. Even some of the church folk were coming against him. But he learned to speak out God's word, to sing to the Lord a new song. And he encouraged himself in the Lord. And it built him up spiritually. It even built him up physically. He said, Lord, shall I go and overtake this troop? Shall I pursue? And the Lord said, yes. And in verse 8 of 1 Samuel 30, verse 8, the Lord said, yes, son, you shall overtake and pursue. For without fail, you shall recover all. So the reason why I'm sharing these 15 reasons to be and stay encouraged is to remind you that without fail, you will recover all. All right? If it can happen to David, it can happen to you. If it can happen to you, it can happen to me. If it can happen to me, it can happen to you. All right, you got it. All right. Encouragement to receive confidence, support, to allow someone to hold up your arms. I need people around me not to pull them down, but to lift them up. Thank God for you. To support, to give you hope, to give you courage, Tonight I pray that what I shared here just in Zechariah 14:9 gave you greater hope for your future. Gave you greater hope for boot camp. All right? And there are many more definitions. Many more definitions. But the more you encourage yourself in the Lord, and you come to church and you get encouraged, and you read your Bible and you get encouraged. Yeah. And the more you encourage yourself, or the more you allow the Holy Spirit to encourage you, because ultimately it's Him, the more it starves fear, it starves doubt and unbelief and discouragement. Yes. Yeah. Folks, it's worked for me for almost 65 years. It's worked for us at 28 years as a church. It worked for me 47 years in ministry. God's faithful. It works. Okay, number one, He has a plan and purpose for your life. Jeremiah 29:11. And again, forgive me for going fast, but if I go back to the very beginning and start reading these verses again, it's going to take us quite some time to finish this. And I really believe, and I'm in no rush, but I really believe the Lord has something else after this series, okay? But we have to still keep encouraging ourselves, and you can always go back to this, okay? So it's really not ending if you think of it that way. Number one, He has a plan and purpose for your life. Jeremiah 29:11. Yay! Number two, the Lord is on your side. Yay!
Yes.
Psalm 118:6, Romans 8:31. Number three, He will never leave you. Yay. He'll never forsake you. Yes. He's got your back. Yay!
Yes.
That's Deuteronomy 31:6. And Hebrews 13:5. Okay, number four. His love for you is unconditional, and He will never stop loving you. Yay! Yeah. That's Jeremiah 31:3. He loves you with an everlasting love. Number four. That was four I gave you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, five. What you're going through is only temporary. This too shall pass. Yay! Yeah. I like that. That's number five. 2 Corinthians 4:17-18. Number six, He is consistent. He never changes. His promises remain. He was, is, and always will be. He always was, always will be your healer, your protector, your provider, your deliverer. Everybody said, yay! Mm-hmm. That's Hebrews 13:8. He's consistent. He never changes. His promises remain. And folks, these promises have no expiration date. Yay! Okay, number seven. According to Psalm 103:12, according to Psalm 103:12 and John 6:37, Psalm 103:12, John 6:37, number seven. He forgives you all the time. He forgives me all the time when I come to Him. He forgives me all the time, no matter what I have done. He said, He who comes to me, I will no wise cast out. As far as the east is from the west, that's how far I've removed your sin and your transgression. So number seven, He forgives us all the time, no matter what we have done. Yay!
Yay!
Number eight, He does not condemn you. Ooh, that's a big one. He does not condemn you. He does not condemn me. I thank God for my upbringing. I really do. I thank God for the church that I grew up in. I really, really do. But sometimes there was some stuff that now I understand was some condemnation. And I don't blame them. They were good people. But thank God, according to His word, Romans 8:1, to those who are in Christ and walk in the Spirit, therefore there is now, Romans 8:1, there is now no condemnation to those who are in Christ. So He doesn't condemn you. He does not condemn you. He'll convict you, but He won't condemn you. So number eight, He does not condemn you. Romans 8:1. Yay!
Yay!
This is all unrehearsed, by the way. We didn't plan. God's doing incredible things tonight. Love you all so much. And hit that like button. Let me know you're out there too. It's our way of, you know, of accountability as well. And thank you for engaging. Whether you're commenting or not, if you're commenting, that's fine. If you're not, that's fine too. Just so long as we all remain engaged. Are you ready, guys? Yay!
Yay!
There you go. All right. All right. Number nine. He's given you faith to overcome the world. He's given you faith to overcome anything. That's 1 John 5:4. That's how God gave us the name for World Overcomers Church. World Overcomers Church. I was driving one night to a Cubs game, a Cubs baseball game, and the Lord just dropped that in my spirit and a friend of mine simultaneously. 1 John 5:4. He's given us faith to overcome the world. So why be encouraged? Why stay encouraged? Because He's given you faith to overcome the world. He's given you faith to overcome anything. 1 John 5:4. Yay! Number 10. I like this one a lot. I like them all. I like them all. Yep. Number 10. And I declare this upon you. I told you last week, I pray this upon you daily. Yep. Number 10. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Isaiah 54:17. Isaiah 54:17. No weapon formed against you shall prosper, but every tongue that rises against you shall fall and be condemned. For this is the heritage of the child of God. But I declare over you, and even now, no weapon formed against you, your family, your loved ones, shall prosper in Jesus' name. That's number 10, and that's Isaiah 54:17. Yay! Number 11. I love this. He will restore you. He's doing it. Yes. We're in a season of restoration. Yes. We're in the times. And seasons of restoration of all things. Of all things. He will restore you. Psalm 23:3. He restores your soul. That's important. That's your will, your mind, your emotions. He restores your heart. Psalm 51:12. Hear this one. Psalm 51:12. He will restore your joy. He will restore your joy. Oh, let me read that one. Let me read that one to you. Psalm 51:12. Let me get it here. Psalm 51:12. Yep. David, I love Psalm 51. You know, after he sinned, he said, take not thy Holy Spirit from me, a broken and a contrite heart, you'll never turn down. But in verse 12, David said, restore to me the joy of your salvation. Wow. Restore to me, Lord, the joy of your salvation. Remember, salvation comes from the Lord. And David cried out right here. He said, Lord, restore to me the joy. Restore to me the joy of your salvation. Remember, your salvation is not based on you. It's based on what the Lord's done. Yes, Lord. So I thank God today. He's restoring your soul. He's restoring your joy. And Jeremiah 30:17 says that he will restore your health. He will restore your health. And there's many facets of restoration. So number 11, he will restore you. Why? Why be encouraged? Why stay encouraged? Because he's going to restore you. Yeah. And that's how you can stay encouraged. You can stay encouraged by remembering he will restore you. He has restored you.
Yes.
He is restoring you.
Yes.
And he will restore you.
Yes.
He was, he is, and is to come. So number 11, he will restore you, is restoring you, will restore you. Yeah! Yeah. Number 12, I love this. Jesus prays for you constantly. Uh-huh. Jesus prays for you constantly. He is your great intercessor. That's Romans 8:34 and Hebrews 7:25. Romans 8:34 and Hebrews 7:25. See, I know you're being encouraged. I know that you are being encouraged. I'm being encouraged. Yes, in Romans 8:34. Who is he who condemns? Is it Christ who died and furthermore is risen? Who is even seated at the right hand of God? Who makes intercession for us? No, he does not. He's not the one who condemns. We already discussed that one. Okay, but it says here that he sits at the right hand of God making intercession for you and making intercession for me. And it also says that in Hebrews 7:25. So in Romans 8:34 and Hebrews 7:25, Jesus is your great intercessor. So when you don't know how to pray, or when your faith is weak, or when you're feeling down and out, now remember, you have to keep pushing, but know this, be encouraged. Jesus, your older brother, is right there interceding for you. And remember, like I pray the Lord's Prayer. I think you know this by now. I pray it every day. I pray it every day. And when it starts out, our Father. Notice it doesn't say my Father or your Father. It's our Father. And who taught us this prayer? Jesus. What is Jesus saying? That God is not only his Father, but God is your Father.
Yes.
That makes Jesus your brother.
Yes.
Woo!
Yes.
Come on, give me a woo! Wow. He's constantly praying for Jimmy. He's constantly praying for you, Mama. I love it. I love it. I love it. And you know what the devil tries to do while Jesus is praying? The Bible says he's the accuser of the brethren. And he tries to make accusations against you and I. And he tries to get as close to the throne as he can, but he's not allowed in. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody just comment, thank you, Lord Jesus. Yep. Thank you, Lamb of God. Wow. All right here. That's number 12. Number 13, I love this. The Holy Spirit lives inside of you. Why be encouraged? Why stay encouraged? Because the Holy Spirit lives within you. I'll say it again. The Holy Spirit lives within you. The Holy Spirit lives within me. Remember in John 14, John chapter 14, verses 16 and 17, he said to his disciples, I'm going to go up, but the Holy Spirit's going to come down. I dwelt with you, and the Holy Spirit's going to dwell in you. Man, oh man, I love that. I love that, I love that. I had my first encounter before my fifth birthday, thereabouts. My first encounter with the Holy Spirit in a hospital room in Queens, New York City. I love the precious Holy Spirit. Yep. So number 13, right? Number 13.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit lives inside of you to empower you, to strengthen you, to guide you, to help you, and to comfort you. And he'll never speak anything contrary to God's word. I heard people say, well, the Lord spoke to me. It's got to line up with the word. That's why there's safety in the multitude of counsel. Wise counsel. But Romans 8:11, oh, I love this verse. Romans 8:11 says, but if the Spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells, not a visitation, a habitation, dwells in us, he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies to his Spirit who indwells within you. So number 13, the Holy Spirit lives in you. Jesus is in heaven praying for you, and the Holy Spirit is inside of you, and he strengthens you. And the word even says in Romans 8:26 that he makes intercession for you. He makes intercession for you. I love it. So when you're weak in prayer or confused about prayer, the Holy Spirit lives inside of you, and he is making intercession for you. He makes intercession for me. He makes intercession for you. He makes intercession for all of us. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses. For when we do not know how to pray as we ought to, the Holy Spirit is there to help us pray. And he prays with us. He prays through us. And sometimes he does the praying with groanings that are too deep for words. That's what you call heavy duty intercession, where the Holy Spirit takes over completely. I've been there. That's an incredible place. So know this, that the Holy Spirit lives in you. He strengthens you.
Yes.
He guides you.
Yes.
He comforts you.
Yes.
He's the parakletos in the Greek, comforter. He comforts you. He aids you. He strengthens you. That's what he does. So remember this, you have him praying and you have Jesus praying. Think about that. And if any two shall agree about anything. Now, if Pastor Derek and I agree, or Joe Spiperi and I agree, there's power there. That's humanity praying. But when you get divinity praying, when you get Jesus and the Holy Spirit together praying, and you involved, two are better than one, but a three-chord strand is not easily broken. Somebody ought to shout right now. Come on. Shout again. Come on. Let me hear you at home. Wow. So number 13, the Holy Spirit lives in you. He empowers you. He strengthens you. He guides you. He helps you. He comforts you. He helps pray. And he does it all. He's inside of you. Come on, let's give him a woo! All right.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit is right. Thank you, Holy Spirit is right. Now number 14, I'm going to put these two together because you're going to see by this verse that I'm going to share with you why I put them together. And that's 1 Corinthians 10:13. 1 Corinthians. Are we having fun, guys?
Yes.
Yeah. But we've had a serious time of a breakthrough in prayer for people, right?
Yes.
for our nation as well, okay?
Amen.
So I'm going to put 14, but I'm going to give you two, but it's still going to be categorized under 14. And that's grace and mercy. You've been hearing a lot lately about his mercies that triumph over judgment, but we're going to put grace and mercy together. So 15 reasons to be and stay encouraged. Number 14 will be because his grace and mercy will help you whatever it is you're going through. I'll say it again. Whatever it is you're going through, his grace and mercy is there to aid you, to guide you. That's his grace and his mercy. All right? Hebrews 4:16. Hebrews 4:16 and 1 Corinthians 10:13. 1 Corinthians 10:13. I'm going to read it to you. 1 Corinthians 10:13. Yeah, here we go. No temptation has overtaken you except which is common to man, but God, who is faithful, will not allow you to be tempted to be tempted beyond which you are able, but with the temptation will also make a way of escape that you will be able to bear it.
Amen.
That's what you call grace.
Yes.
That's divine intervention.
Yes.
That's another definition for grace. That's not allowing you to go through more than you can't bear. That's mercy. All right? But let's define that even more. Let's look at what Hebrews has to say regarding his grace and mercy. He gives us grace and mercy in time of need. Hebrews 4:16. And this will further identify grace and mercy combined here. And again, that's Hebrews 4:16. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of what? Grace. Throne of what?
Grace.
Throne of what?
Grace.
That we may obtain what?
Mercy.
And find what?
Grace.
So you see how they go back and forth. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace. See, when you don't walk in condemnation, it becomes easier. Let us come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in time of need. One more time. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in time of need. So that's 14. His grace and his mercy will help us in time of need. I know I could have separated them, but I wanted to keep this verse intact and keep them together. You get it. And now number 15. You ready? Number 15. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish. Think about that. Folks, you're never going to perish. You're never going to perish.
Amen.
Think about
Amen.
It. Your body will, but you won't.
That's right.
Your body will, but you won't. I mean, unless we're raptured.
Mm-hmm.
But it wouldn't be something if the Lord returned tonight.
Yeah.
Wow. But number 15. What's number 15? 15 reasons to be and stay encouraged. John 3:16. Why? Because he's promised us eternal life in heaven.
Thank you.
So folks, don't quit.
Mm-hmm.
Don't think thoughts of anything contrary to longevity and to living and to life. He's come that we might have life and life more abundantly. So number 15, he has promised us eternal life in heaven. And that's why I shared with you a couple weeks ago that what you're going through, number 5, what you're going through is only temporary. Because ultimately, while he wants to deliver us now, and he is, we have eternal life. That's why we need to live with an eternal perspective. For God so loved the world.
Jesus.
People say, I prayed for a healing. Where's the miracles? The greatest miracle is you. That means being born again. The greatest miracle meaning you is that you're born again. You're the miracle speaking. You're the miracle that works up every day. God's the miracle worker.
Yes.
Jesus is
yes.
the miracle worker.
Yes.
But you're the living proof The fact that tonight I can ask him to forgive me and he cleanses me as if it never happened. That's justification. Justified. Just as if I've never sinned. That doesn't mean I should take advantage of the process. No. Or the system. No. But we have eternal life. With a day that will be when our Jesus we shall see. We're going to see him face to face. Oh, what a day that will be. But until that time, we're going to grind it out. Somebody comment, we're going to grind it out. We're in boot camp, like Mark Lowry said. We're in boot camp. But again, in boot camp, we not only survive, but we revive and we thrive. But there's coming a day that we'll have our eternal peace and healing. So there you have 15 reasons to be and stay encouraged. I'd encourage you folks, if you've been taking notes on this, to maybe put this in your computer and print it out and make a copy of it and put it next to your bed or something or on your refrigerator. Seriously, because you're worth it. Amen. Remember Joshua 1:8-9. If you're diligent to meditate therein on God's word in the morning and in the evening and in the in-between time, you'll have success. You will make your way prosperous. Ultimately, the Lord doing it, right? Yes. So I've given you 15, but here we go. Because you've been wonderful students, I'm going to give you a bonus. Right. Because you've been wonderful students, I'm going to give you a bonus. All right? And here it is. Revelation 3:21. You've heard this before, many of you have, but let this just be an encouragement to you. Revelation 3:21, and let me tell you, Jesus is talking to the church. Jesus is talking to you. This is a bonus. All right? Revelation 3:21. To him who overcomes. Well, that's you. Because we found out in number nine, he gives you faith to overcome anything, right? 1 John 5:4. So that's you. So to you, Encounter Church. To you, Facebook family and friends. To him who overcomes. Listen to this. I will grant, allow, permit to sit with me on my throne. Wow. To him who overcomes. That's why you're a world overcomer.
Yes.
That's why we encounter his presence. That's why we need each other. We need him, his anointing. That's what this church is known for. We have other good ministries as well, but it's the anointing that breaks and destroys the yoke. To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit on my throne with me. For as I have overcome and sat down with my Father on my throne. Folks, he will share his glory with no one. He'll share his glory with no one. He'll share his glory with no one. But the day's going to come that he's going to look at you. Now I'm looking at my phone for the first time. He's going to say, Nancy, Eileen, Mama Boehner, Norma, Mark, Amy, Sally, Marisol, Lori, Arlene, Amy, Candy, Sandy, name the names, babe. Patrick, look at all of you.
Jeffrey,
look at them all. There's so many here, it's hard to keep up with.
Donna.
Ken.
Patrick.
Sherry. Derek. All of you. Look at them all. Lourdes.
Nydia.
Pastor Joni, Jack Frost, Glenn, Andrea,
yes,
all of you, folks, whether I call your name or not, whether I call your name or not, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. This is just a phone. This is just a phone. So whether I call your name or not, whether I call your name or not, Cora, whether Ida, Sally, whether I call your name or not, your name is in the Lamb's Book of Life. Pam, your name is in the Lamb's Book. Candy, your name is in the Lamb's Book of Life. Your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Play it, Pastor Derek. Play it. Play it. Come on, son. Come on. Your name. Your name. Somebody say, somebody comment, my name. Somebody say, my name. Just those two words, my name. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Your name. Your name is in there. Now, Father, in Jesus' name, we seal this word by the power of the Holy Spirit. Too much is given, much is required. Lord, I've studied, I've prepared, and the people have taken it well. They've received your word, Lord. They've received your word. So now it's sealed into our hearts that we not only would be encouraged, but we would encourage others. That we would encourage others. For all the youth. Each and every one. Yeah, Bonnie. Yeah, Norma. Yeah, Kayleen. Each and every one. Whether I say your name or not, whether I say your name or not, your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. In the Lamb's Book of Life, your name is written. So we thank you, Father, for what you've done tonight. We give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' name. For the way we praised him, worshiped him, sang a new song, did warfare, told jokes, preached the word, you've been great. You're not a great audience, you're a great army. Love you so much. Now let's worship the Lord with our giving, because the Lord loves a cheerful giver. So this is time right now to honor the Lord. Offerings. Oblations, to honor the Lord with oblations, with the first fruits of all of our increase. You can go to the website right now. You can go right now. You can go right now to ourencounter.com with tithes, offerings, first fruits, oblations. You could swing by the church even tonight and put it in the black secured mailbox. Yep, I said it. You can call the church. If you get a voicemail, somebody will call you back. They will. You can mail it in. But tonight, as if we were in the building. See, right now it's empty. Right now it's empty. But we're believing God that through this Wednesday night service, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over into your bosom. Into your bosom. Yes. This is your season of multiplication.
Yes.
This is your hour. Yes. Pastor Joni's been reading praise reports on Sunday. You're hearing them live with your ears. So on behalf of the First Lady, we pray you have a tremendous Thursday, fabulous Friday, sensational Saturday, and super Sunday. Honor your ticket to God's favor. These 15 reasons plus one, the bonus, it's sealed now. We love you so much. If our arms were long enough, we'd give you one big hug. If our lips were big enough, we'd give you one big kiss. Pastor Joni was up here earlier, but the anointing just went in a different direction. just went in a different direction. Babe, just tell the people good night if you would. So on behalf of First Lady and myself, we love you. We'll see you on Sunday. Remember that seed you're sowing tonight, we declare multiplication. The tithe that's holy to God. 15 reasons plus one. Oh, and remember, Jeff Glass, in my house, I am the general. My wife, she is Patricia, she's the major. He said, I make the general decisions and she makes the major decisions. Woohoo! We love you. We've warred tonight. Remember, we're in boot camp, but we're not just surviving, we're thriving, and we are reviving in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you so much, church. We love you. We love you. We love you. Heaven's best be upon you now and forevermore. One more time, Pastor Derek. Come on. Sing.
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King.
Come on!
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King.
Come on!
Soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we're going to see.
Now listen to this, listen to this, listen to this.
No more crying there. We are going to see the King.
What?
No more crying there. We are going to see the King. No more crying there. We are going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to see the King. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to see the King.
Stay right there. Stay right there. Stay right there. What time is it? 8:28. Romans 8:28. And we know all things work together for good to those that love God, called according to His purpose. Love you. Let it be a confirmation. Good night. God bless you. We love you.